Somebody had hidden my thumbs, so it took a really long time. But I'm here, right? So let's go.
You know, you've written a book, haven't you? Neil's Book of the Dead. What's this all about?
Where'd you get that from?
I stole it.
I left that on the bus, right? And like...
What's in it?
Oh, no, some heavy publisher's got hold of it, right, and they're exploiting it, right? That's really bad. Look, Neil's Book of the Dead. £4.95. Complete rip-off.
Do you like pop music? Who are your favourite artists?
Dr. Strangely Strange. But Oddly Normal. I quite like Principal Edward's Magic Theatre.
Right. It's certainly going to be interesting to see what you think of this lot then. Record number one. If you're well up on your Chinese current affairs, you'll know that 1984 is the year of the rat. So who knows, maybe this year will be the year of Modest Bob Geldof and his Boomtown Rats. They've been off the scene for ages. Their latest single, Drag Me Down, is their latest stab at the charts, though. Actually, it's their best for ages. Anyway, here's the boys, Mick and the Picks, in the mines. Take it away, Bob. The Rats back with Drag Me Down. Neil, first impressions on that one?
Yeah, ha ha. I suppose you thought it was a really funny idea, right? Like getting me to review a single called Drag Me Down. I suppose you thought that'd be a really good joke, yeah.
We did actually.
Yeah, because you thought I'd drag you all down, right? Well, the joke's on you, right? The joke.
What do you think of the record, though?
But the record? Well, it was quite good. I like, there's a bit at the end, right, where there's like big trumpets and everything. And I really like that bit. So it's quite nice when it ends. And I only just saw the video for the first time. That's brilliant, the video. Yeah, it's quite topical as well, isn't it, with all the miners and
yeah,
everything.
Flying pickets. What is there to say about Wham, that dynamic duo with the permanent suntan? As far as the nation was concerned, Club Tropicana was the place to be last summer. Whether you continue to think of did you like that one?
Well, I mean, you know, like the singing was really good, right? And the production was good, right? And the song's brilliant, right? And, you know, the rhythm's good. It really makes you want to, like, party. I hated it.
Do you dance yourself?
Yeah, I can dance, yeah.
What sort of stuff do you dance to?
Well, you know, anything really. I mean, I don't dance to music or anything.
Says it. Right, Ultravox videos have never been simple affairs. Not the obligatory band just playing their number in front of the camera job. If you remember Vienna, you'll remember how over the top that was. With their new waxing, Dancing With Tears In My Eyes is pretty cataclysmic as well, prophesying the nuclear holocaust. Directed by the band's mid-year, Steven Spielberg, beware.
Try.
when the world blew up about a minute later. What did you think of that one, Neil?
Well, I mean, you know, it was all right. I thought they were a lot better before they got Jeremy Irons as the lead singer. You know.
No, mid-year, mid-year.
What?
It was mid-year.
Mid-year? What's that?
You just saw him. Did you like it?
Oh, well, yeah, I mean, it's quite an exciting film, isn't it?
But, is that something that you worry about, you know, the nuclear holocaust yourself?
Well, yeah, you know, I've had a few, you know, but once you've had a few, you kind of get used to them, you know what I mean?
As well as presenting this extravaganza, I occasionally DJ like a lot of other people in various clubs. And every now and then, a surefire dance hit will explode across the country's clubs. A couple of years ago, one such record was Rocker's Revenge, Walking on Sunshine. Last year, it was Monyaka's Go De Yucca. At the moment, the record currently filling the dance floors is Jamaican singer Paul Blake and the Bloodfire Posse and the groovy Rubber Dub Soldier. Here's a few Rubber Dub Soldiers found from the 50s.
I'm just a Rubber Dub Soldier, fighting to keep the rockers alive. Oh, I'm just a rub-a-dub soldier, fighting to keep the rockers alive. I'm a new recruit of the rub-a-dub army. I'm a private marching confidently, stepping through the battlefield with success, just to prove that the rockers are the best. Because I'm just a rub-a-dub soldier, fighting to keep the rockers alive. If it means that I'll have to be working, working from a 9 until 5.
Getting summer in, I wonder what those boys are doing now. Right, that was Paul Blake and the Bloodfire Posse and Rubber Dub Soldier. What did you think of that?
Oh, that was brilliant. That's really good, that song.
That really sent you away somewhere, didn't it?
Yeah, oh, that was far out, you know what I mean? It was really good. Hey, like, you know, I've been meaning to say this, like, you've got, like, really long hair, you know, I think that's really good, like... Are we on television? Oh, no. Oh,
Neil,
wow.
Neil, would you like one of the records to take home back to your squat?
What, if I had to take a record, which record would I take? I'd take, well, couldn't I just have a cassette, like, of all of them?
Yeah, seeing as it's you, yeah, you can. Right, thanks. Now, coming up after the break, the 60s phenomenon which refuses to die, and Love Wars from Womack and Womack, and pop music's real underground story on the black music recorded in back rooms and sold on the streets.